Divya Nyanasundari Rajashekaran. She is graduated in architecture from Thyagarajar College of Engineering, Madurai. She has also pursued her master's in arts at Stella Maris, Chennai. She's worked as an architect at the Dinakaran Engineers and Property Developers, Bangalore. She's worked on apartment buildings, residential buildings, and office buildings. Her interest and passion for arts pave ways to conduct various classes at Chennai, Bangalore. Her works have been published online in International Artist Portfolio magazine. She's completed more than 60 painting works. She's currently running her studio for arts and architecture, RAD Designs, principally focusing on arts ranging from mural designs, canvas paintings, abstracts, etc.
Welcome to UGC series of lectures in Architecture, Art Appreciation, Unit 2, Vocabulary of Art. In this chapter, we are going to deal with the introduction to vocabulary of art, elements in art explained with examples, and principles in art explained with examples as well. For understanding any art, we need to have the basic structure. The basic structure comprises of the components of art, elements of art, principles of design, and the underlying concepts behind that. So, taking a closer look into it, we'll have a look at the elements of art. What are the elements of art, and what are the basic principles of design, and what are the components of art? All these together needs to form the unity, that is orderness and oneness in any art medium. Let's have a closer look at the elements of art. What are the elements of art? The value, line, color, texture, mass, and shape forms the elements of art. And the principles of design, harmony, emphasis, proportion, balance, economy, rhythm, and variety forms the principles of art. These together forms the components, which contains the subject, form, and content. All these together need to be in unity, forming the order and oneness in the art. Let's study in detail about the various elements of art. The various visual elements of art. The line, which is a very basic thing. Line is an identical path of a point moving in a space. It can vary in width, direction, and in length. There are various types of lines, as we all know, and we use in our daily lives and art and architecture as well. Horizontal, vertical, diagonal, zigzag, and curved lines. This is an example of the diagonal line. The eye line of these kids is shown. This is a curved line, you could see, which is incorporated in this painting. The vertical line in this element, the zigzag line, the truss pattern, and the diagonal line. This is an artwork by Piet Mondrian, the Broadway Boogie Boogie. We could see the use of vertical and horizontal line forms interesting shapes of varying sizes, as you could see. Let's have a look at the basic shapes, the geometric and the organic shapes. The square, rectangle, hexagon, triangle, as we are very familiar with right from age-old days. This is an example by Piet Mondrian, as he is known for the composition using basic forms. These are the examples for the basic forms and the organic shape used in this landscape painting by Kandinsky. Let's have a short exercise with whatever you have gone through till now. Taking a closer look into the spiral design, this spiral design is formed by using just the lines. So, we could see how interesting shapes could be made using just the lines, and try creating interesting pattern using this spiral design. And create a three-dimensional work by just using lines, not planes, just lines. The wireframe structure would be your result. Make it interesting. Propose a 3D work using just the geometric shapes. Propose a 3D work using just the organic shapes. Value. What is the value? The tones from lighter to darker forms the value, and the opposite of this forms the shades. How value could be created? Looking into this image of the sheep by Henry Moore, the degree of line concentration indicates the value of the subject. Wherever the line concentration is more, the depth of the subject is seen, and thus the shape is formed. Line defining shape, texture, and shadows. This is an imaginary product of the artist. In this image, you could see the play of light, the textures, and the shape of various objects the artist has created just by using the pencils. you could see the interesting use of lines and the varied diagonal, the horizontal diagonal and zigzag patterns of the line and the play of light. If not for the play of light, this picture wouldn't have been so interesting. Shape. This is a famous picture. All of you must have come across this. The Water Lilies by Claude Monet. He was more interested in the effect of light. The effect of light on this image defines the shape. The shape of the lilies and leaves here is defined by the use of light. The texture. You could see the textures clearly defined in this particular image. Especially in the center, you could see the play of textures, and probably a comb-like structure must be used to produce designs like this in between. So, thus creating an interesting pattern. Texture could be seen as actual and visual texture. What an actual texture is? In art, an actual texture is, this is an object made of fur. So, we all know texture of a fur. In that way, we could feel it. This is an ivory mask by an unknown artist. We all know the texture of ivory, hence by looking at the image, we will be able to feel the exact texture of the ivory. And this is an olive tree by Van Gogh. By looking at this painting, we could feel the texture of this. It means we are feeling the texture of the painting. As if in this, we are feeling the texture of the fur and the texture of the ivory in this. What are visual textures? In this picture, various vegetables are represented to form this portrait. The onion, the radish, the tomatoes, etc. We all know the textures of these objects. Hence, visually we are able to feel the texture. That's the visual texture. It's a dirty leaf, probably a pencil sketch of a dirty leaf. So, by the title and by looking at the painting, we could visually feel how a dirty leaf could be probably, and the texture of a leaf could be felt. And from this image of the portrait, by use of light, we are able to feel the texture of the cloth. Thus, the visual texture and the actual texture varies. Color. Color and the elements play a vital role in art. As we all know, the blue, red and yellow forms the primary colors, and the violet, orange and green form the secondary colors, and thus the evolution of the tertiary colors like red, violet, red, orange, yellow, orange, yellow, green, blue, green and blue, violet. Let's see how colors have played a role in this particular picture. This picture has made vital use in play of warm and cold colors. As we all know, warm colors consist of red, orange, yellow, and the cool colors consist of lighter shades of blue and green, blue, green, gray, etc. The use of warm and cool colors makes the fruit advance. The cool colors used for the background and for the cloth, and the warm colors used for the fruit and the basket makes the fruit enhanced, thus making the fruit advance and recede rather than merely indicating a change in the value. In this picture, the colors have played a vital role in a way such that cool colors have been used for the foreground and warm colors have been used for the background, enhancing the backdrop area, which is usually a reversal in general paintings. Space. The space in this picture, this is an image of early Dutch landscape. Aiming at the maximum illusion of visual reality emphasized the concept of infinite space. We could see the diminishing landscape, and actually we could feel the space in this particular painting. The perspective moves wide, and the atmosphere and the sky and the landscapes are portrayed so beautifully that we could actually feel the space. Principles of design. The principles of design constitute the harmony, balance, rhythm, variety, proportion and economy. Unity. The unity in an image is achieved when the elements of the image work together to form an orderliness, harmony and a completeness. Unity can be achieved through various elements such as line, color and using similar shapes. Having a closer look at this image, similar shapes have been used. Though the shape is not exactly definable, similar shapes and colors and a grid based composition establish unity in this painting. Harmony. Harmony may be thought of as a factor of cohesion relating to various picture parts. In this picture, the artist has created harmony by using repeated curves of varying sizes, and he has made it interesting by showing variety by varying the shapes of these curves and by varying the colors, thus creating a harmony in this picture. Rhythm. One attribute to repetition is its ability to produce rhythm. In this picture, the forward movement of the people represents rhythm. Here you could see the clear sketch of the rhythmic movement of the people in line. And even the whole picture by itself is composed in a rhythmic pattern, like in not just the people moving here, even the person with hats, even this forms a rhythmical movement. Variety. Variety is the counterweight to harmony. It is the other side of organizing, essential to utility. In this picture, the artist has pushed the balance strongly in the direction of variety. In this 3D work, various shapes and sizes the objects have been placed, and the another important thing is the light which is placed right above this. It defines the shape even more, and with a greater reflection, it provides enduring vitality. Balance. In art, there is a balance when the parts of the image have same visual weight, and it could be classified as symmetrical balance, asymmetrical balance, and radial balance. The controlled balance and tension. Having a closer look into the image, the artist has created a tension between the two persons standing in the foreground with the number one on top of the wall, thus creating a tension between them. And the darker values of the building above counterweight with that on the left hand side of the building, with that of the person standing in the front. Coming to the symmetrical balance. Symmetrical balance displays a portion of image on one side with the format repeated on the other side. One should be very careful in forming a symmetrical balanced art, such that it should not be monotonous or a boring composition, since both the sides have the same image or the same format. Looking into this example, The Twin Sisters by Ettore, this image is balanced vertically. The image on one side is replicated to the other side, but the monotonicity of this image is broken by the intricate details which are given here. Approximate symmetrical balance. The usual or general boring qualities in a symmetrical artwork could be modified in this with minor deviations. In this picture, which is vertically symmetrical, the monotonicity is broken by the lively figures beneath. Radial symmetry. Radial balance revolves around an imaginary or a real central point that is frequently divergent from some source, usually from the center. Here the rays seems divergent from the central point, which is imaginary in this. The rays are widely placed, and while moving, the rays become closer, thus creating an interesting pattern in radial balance. Coming to the proportion. Proportion deals with the ratio of the individual parts to one another, but mostly proportion is a personal matter of judgment for each artist. This is an example of Doryphorus by Polyclitus. Polyclitus has created a new system for proportion, which has led to the formation of a young man. You could see his beautiful proportion of this young man in this detailed picture. Emphasis. The particular place in the picture has to be made dominant either by some shapes or by vibrant colors. In this image, the focal point is the bright center, and you could see the swirling atmosphere, the landscape, and the people standing here. In spite of all this, our attention moves to this part, that is the power of emphasis. In this picture, it is emphasized by using bright colors. Contrast. Contrast occurs when elements are presented in a way that makes them appear unrelated. In this picture, harmony is provided through use of recurrent shapes of circle, and variety is shown by modifying the shape of the circle, like some are tapered, some are smaller, and some are bigger than the norm. And contrast is shown by the background of these circles, hence creating an interesting pattern. The movement. Many observers do not realize that while looking at an art, they get carried away by it. They travel along the path of the art, which is directed by the artist, which stops now and then, which makes the artwork and the travel interesting. In this image by Agnes, one travels through the path of this painting. This is a very dominant and a very interesting piece of painting. The voice illuminates this painting as the dominant, large, stark, and unforgettable image. Agnes speaks of the abstract beauty of life, the voice. She further speaks of a delicate plant-like flame that springs out of a plant-like root structure. She portrays this as the root of the structure and the flames moving through which the person viewing it moves along, hence creating a movement in this picture. It is very obvious that this is not a stagnant picture like a rigid square or a rectangle or something like that. This picture shows movement by itself. Economy. What economy in painting and art is? Economy has no rules. Just keeping the minimum, revising it, and if particular thing is not needed, then reworking on it, or it could be rejected. In this piece of work, Wesselmann has reduced the image to few details he considers crucial, thereby practicing economy. It is an example of a nude study by Wesselmann. He has just kept the basic form of the female. No extra details like eyes, nose, etc., or any jewelry, or even no details in the backdrop is given. This is minimalistic. This is so minimalistic that the artist considers as economy. Try out this small exercise, which could be very interesting. Create boxes of 2.5 inches by 2.5 inches of about some 10 to 20 numbers and create pattern using line and point. Try to create harmony, variety, balance, emphasis, rhythm, proportion using the line and point. This would be very useful for you in your designs. What are the components of art? Subject, content, form, style, media and technique. Forms the basic component of art. Let's have a closer look into the subject, content and form of art. Subject. In this painting, it is clearly evident that it is a man-made structure portrayed in this painting. But just the subject doesn't matter. How the subject is being treated matters. This is a work of a factory building, and in the image, verticality is broken by the horizontal windows, and this work even shows the perspective through which it goes, the traffic signal post indicating the roadway. So much of subject is seen in this work. Form. In this image, form could be perceived as the individual object as a form, or the path together forming it. To illustrate the different meaning of term form, we can say form in this piece of sculpture are its parts, largely individual figures, or the form, the work consists of a total assembly of those parts. Content. This picture is a true, real and an unposed one by Eugene. The emotional factor in this picture is so obvious that it would be the same for any kind of subject of this matter. But the artist has enhanced it by the handling of the situation. Since this is a photograph, the camera angle, the setting up of the frame and the situational capture matters a lot in this picture, thus showing its content. Let's have a short exercise for this. Correlate the study of basic elements in art applied into architecture for the buildings which you will be seeing. Analyze how the shape has played a vital role in space modification. Try creating 3D forms with these visual elements you have studied. Incorporate them into your designs, exterior, interior spacing and modeling. Analyze these buildings with the elements you have studied. For example, this could be the vertical line you saw. No? For example, this is for the point, this is for the vertical line, this is for the horizontality, the form and shape. Analyze the form and shape in these structures. The water cube, the Guggenheim Museum, how the form has played a vital role in these structures. The space. The texture of the building in these images. Some would be reflective, glossy, rugged or smooth, anything. Just analyze these textures and how it plays the role in this. Design principles. Here are a few representation of architectural works. Analyze the design principles on these works. These are the examples for symmetry, like how symmetry has played in this. The asymmetrical work, the symmetrical work and the radial symmetry in these images. The rhythm. Emphasis, proportion and scale, movement. How movement is shown in the buildings. While looking at these images, it is very clear that these are not stagnant, fixed plane buildings. While looking at the picture for the first glance itself, you could feel a movement. So, how it is created? The contrast. This is the Louvre. This is the modern glass building, the Louvre. This is a historical building behind that. So, analyze how the architect have played the contrast in the building. Analyze how these buildings have been unified, either by the use of colors, textures or the form by itself. Let's look at a summary of what you have studied. An understanding of various elements of art, line, shape, form, space, color, light, value and texture. An understanding of the principles of art, unity, variety, harmony, rhythm, balance, proportion, emphasis, contrast and movement. Incorporating and analyzing these elements and principles in architecture. Examples are given as excise. Let's have a look at the questions for your chapter. What are the elements of art? What are the principles of art? Define balance in art and the types with examples. What is the difference between value and shade? Differentiate between actual texture and visual texture. Define subject, form and content with respect to art. We have come to the end of this session. Thank you.